This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. This is an introduction to solving rational inequalities, where we only have polynomials in the numerator and denominator. Make sure you already know how to solve nonlinear polynomial inequalities. All right, so first of all, examples of rational inequalities are shown here. Basically, rational means you're going to have a fraction, and you only have polynomials in the numerator and denominator. Remember, 2 could be written as 2 over 1, so that's really still just a fraction, and a constant could also be a polynomial. You don't have to have an x value. Now, solving these is very similar to solving the nonlinear polynomial inequalities, except these fractions we have to pay a little bit more attention to. For instance, you can never have the denominator equal to 0. So if you look at the denominator, which is x minus 3, x minus 3 can never be 0, because then that means this fraction would be undefined. So in other words, what you could determine off the bat are the values that x cannot be. So that's one thing that's going to be a little bit different here. Okay, here are the steps. Pretty similar to solving the other ones on the polynomial inequalities. All right, first we're going to write the inequality with 0 on one side, and then we're going to write as one fraction on the other side and factor the numerator and denominator, okay? Next, we're going to set each factor, both in the numerator and denominator, equal to 0 and solve the equation to find the critical points. And we're going to mark those on a number line. Now, here's the difference. We're going to put a circle on the number line for any critical points from the denominator, because we know those are not solutions, because it would make the fraction undefined. If we have, for the critical points from the numerator, we'll put a circle if we've got greater than or just less than. But if it's less than or greater than or equal to, right, less than or equal or greater than or equal, those will be solutions and we'll put a dot. And then we'll go ahead and test the intervals like we've done before. So here's the first problem. X plus 2 over x minus 3 is less than or equal to 0. So our first step was to make sure we have 0 on one side. And we have that. Second thing is to make sure that we have a single fraction on the left, the other side, and we have that. Third is to make sure we have the numerator and denominator factored, and we have that as well. All right, so those are the first couple steps. Now we want to set all of the factors equal to 0. So x plus 2 equals 0, or x minus 3 equals 0 gives us our critical points. Right, so our critical points are negative 2 and 3, and so we're going to mark those on a number line. Now we have to be careful. The x minus 3 came from the denominator, so I sometimes like to write it this way. I know it can't be 3, so I know I must not include 3 in my solution. X is going to equal negative 2 because I have the less than or equal symbol. So look at this. If you put a negative 2 into this original inequality, you would have 0 over negative 5. Okay, so in other words, plug in negative 2. You'd have negative 2 plus 2 over negative 2 minus 3, less than or equal to 0. Is that true? Well, 0 over negative 5 is less than or equal to 0, because you have 0 is equal to 0. So that's fine. That means negative 2 is a solution. So because it had this equal symbol, that critical point is a solution. That's similar to what we did with the polynomial inequalities. All right. Now, if this was less than, strictly less than, then both of these would have circles, right? But in all cases, the critical point that came from the denominator must have a circle on it. And now we do our test points just like we did with the polynomial inequalities. So let's pick a number less than negative 2. So how about we try negative 10? All right, so we're going to take the fraction and plug in negative 10. So in the numerator, if I plug in negative 10, negative 10 plus 2 is a negative number, so I have a negative number. And in the denominator, if I plug in negative 2, I also have a negative number. Because negative 2 minus, I'm sorry, if I plug in negative 10, said that backwards, negative 10 minus 3 is also a negative number. And what's a negative divided by a negative? It's a positive number. All right, now let's test a point between negative 2 and 3. Zero's in there. I always do 0 if it's in the interval. So try 0 for x. So in the numerator, if I put in 0 for x, I get a positive number at the top, right? 0 plus 2 is positive. And in the denominator, 0 minus 3 is negative. And a positive number divided by a negative number is negative. And then we'll pick something in the other interval bigger than 3. So how about we try 5? All right, so in the numerator, 5 plus 2, that's positive. And in the denominator, 5 minus 3 is also positive. And a positive number divided by a positive number is positive. Now, what do we want for our solution set? We want where it's going to be negative, less than or equal to 0. So we want this part in between negative 2 and 3. So we put that in here. And if we're going to write our solution in interval notation. All right, so we've got all the numbers starting at negative 2, so it includes negative 2. And it goes up to 3. And that's our solution. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.